Now, think on these things. When you create your own money and you hand it off to the retailer or the bank and they dishonor your private money, you can recommend that they send it off to the Treasury, and the Treasury will happily pay them. The Treasury will exchange my money and turn it into their money. So therefore, the Treasury is the currency exchange office. Now, all the retail company wants is they just want money that they recognize that they use in their own system. When they see your own created paper money, they say, whoa, this is foreign to me. So you have to remind them, well, just go to the exchange office and exchange it. That's another option you can do. You can either hire the gun, or you can tell them, just send it off to the Treasury. And give them a copy of your commercial lien and your security agreement. Or the website. Just give them the website. And it also probably would help if you had your birth certificate accepted for value and you had a set-off bond. But in my world, you don't really need that. That's just to be safe. Once you put a lien of commercial jurisdiction on that corporate application bond, it is the birth certificate. It does represent the birth certificate. That birth certificate application bond is just the application that Mama filled out that gives now permission to create a birth certificate title. So when you put a lien on the application bond, you have just also put a lien on the title. But the only reason some people say that you also want to accept your birth certificate for value and write a set-off bond and send it to the Treasury and get a default on their acceptance is because it helps you to think it through in your mind to get your intention going in a direction so you can create your own reality with your intention and attract back your intention. So all the extra paperwork is just a tool to help you. You don't need the extra paperwork if you can get a full understanding right off the bat. But I did do the extra paperwork, and it has given me a full understanding. So there is an advantage to doing it that way. But let's review again, basically, point blank. When you've rebutted the assumption of the public attorney, you are now a private attorney through a security agreement and a commercial lien posted in the public somewhere for everybody to see. It's been witnessed either by a state notary or your friend or someone walking down the sidewalk. Any witness will do. And if you can teach your cat how to sign, he can witness. Just have his paw print go right on the page. There is technology enough to know they can read animal minds, and an animal can be talking and can be printed out on paper. You didn't know that technology existed, did you? Well, it does. Welcome to the real world. This is all in the private. So, when you create your own money and you hand it to the retailer or the banker and they refuse it, You just tell them, all you got to do is take my information with my security agreement, my public lien, and a cop, and this check. Take it to the foreign exchange office, the currency exchange office, and exchange it, and they'll give you paper money. And the currency exchange office of the earth is the Treasury, otherwise known as the International Monetary Fund, called the IMF. That is the IMF, is the International Treasury. It is the foreign exchange office for all currency. When you're the king of your own nation and you rebutted the assumption of the public nation, you can create your own currency. Because your rebuttation, known as your security agreement and your commercial lien, is the judgment of court written on paper. The corporation has agreed, and you have agreed, that you are now private. And you fall under what's called universal law, which supersedes all legal codes and statutes. That is an internationally known recognition system, otherwise known as an international universal peace treaty, where you have proven yourself to be self-educated, responsible, peaceful, and safe, ruling your words and your body actions on this earth to not cause injury and harm to other beings. So therefore, you have the authority to create your own paper money. When you give your paper money to the retailer or the banker and they refuse it, you just recommend all they got to do is go to the currency exchange center and exchange it into their own currency that they deal with. It ain't no different if you were to go to China with American dollars and you handed the retailer American dollar, he's going to look at you like you're some kind of whack nut, probably. And if he's a smart retailer, he won't look at you as a whack nut. He'll have some wisdom and understanding, and he'll say, I can take this to the International Exchange Center and get Chinese yens or Japanese yens, whatever country you're at. It's time to wake up, people, and understand how this world simply operates, don't you think? Now you know why I'm the prince. Because I have simplified everything for you in powerful language. And I can also be nice and kind too. But I'm in a powerful mood right now. Because you're going to hear us roar! Because I just called the military in. Because I sent my information to the big gun. But that's what it took in order for me to get this video that I just made right now. I could have just as well as told them to send it off to the foreign exchange place and exchanged it. So now I'm see how these videos help me to improve in my knowledge? And you can do the same. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Remember, once you understand the principles that rule the earth, the universe, you are a powerful mofla. Get down with your clowns. Because I'm behind you, and I'm here to help you all the way.